I will show data, official data, mostly from two sources. One source, the one for mortality and incidence figures, are from the WHO IRC Globcam 2002, and instead for the trends and survival and the prevalence, the data come from the well-known Eurocare Europreval study, which was conducted for, some years ago. Let me see whether... No, it's not. Ah, okay. We speak about the large Europe, the 27 countries Europe. So the data are referred to for the incidence and mortality figure to this area. And as you can see, there are very important and dramatic, even dramatic differences, if you see. Look here for incidence. Here you have a column. This is the incidence, and this is the mortality figures for males and females. And first of all, Europe, this larger Europe, represents around 28% of both incidence and mortality for colorectal cancer in the world. And you see very huge differences. Just take some examples. Look here at Greece with a standardized rate of 19.4 against the Czech Republic 58.5, so nearly more than the double. And the same you can see for deaths. There are huge differences, both in male and female, and that means that Europe is not one country. Still, also for the mortality and incidence of colorectal cancer, there are very, very important inequalities. This is just to give you the same data. You see on a graphic format, and you see where the highest incidence is in those, you see here and here. Okay, what is of interest are the trends. What is happening from 1970 to 2005? These, from 1995, these are estimated data extrapolated from the trend in the last 10 years. And you see that there are countries in Europe with still increasing incidence, even if the incidence in the US is still much higher than any European country, but is dropping sharply after 1985, and that has a meaning. We will see about that. There are other countries in Europe with stable incidences: Scotland, Germany, Iceland, Denmark, Sweden, Finland, Austria, and these are more or less stable in incidence. And again, here are plotted the US data from the cancer registries in the US. Now let's speak about mortality. Mortality, as you see, there are countries with rather increasing mortality, still now, in 2007. And these are Spain, Slovenia, Estonia, Poland, Slovakia. There are countries with stable or decreasing mortality, and these are the countries: Italy, Finland, Netherlands, Scotland, France, Sweden. You see, the trend is a downward trend, and this is a good news. But look at the data from the US, which are of interest. The sharp decline in incidence, starting in 1985, more or less, when big screening campaigns were made in in the US. This is of interest because only in few countries in Europe, as you have seen, we see the same pattern. And now we go to the more or most dramatic figures. These are the figures of survival. 1 year survival, 5 year survival after diagnosis, men and women. These are countries which are not part of the 27, and some of the 27 are lacking here because this is the Eurocare study which was made on cancer registries, European cancer registries. And here, really, you see something which is difficult to explain, or perhaps not so difficult to explain. You see the 1 year survival, let's say in Austria, is 73%. The 5 year survival is 50%. If you go to Poland, the 1 year survival is 51%, 1 year, and 26.8% at 5 years. And the same, more or less, you see, Poland, the Czech Republic, you see, are on the lower end of these dramatic statistics. Here you can see the same in graphic expression. And you see how many inequalities we can see in survival, 5 year survival in most of the European countries. Which could be the explanation? The opinion, I think, of most of the gastroenterologists here and oncologists in this room is that is the lack of earlier diagnosis and therefore the lack of screening. That's but it's of interest to see that in any case there was an increase from 1983 to 1994, you see, the overall, these are some examples, but this is the European trend. You see, there is an increase in survival, therefore the situation is improving. But still, and that's even dramatic, you see, all the European countries here, we listed just the top of the and the bottom, Italy, because it's my country, have a 5 year survival which is less than the one in the US. So this is something that again has to push us to find explanations and to try to enforce the measures by which we have this big difference. One reason relies in this graphic. This is the overall, not colon cancer, overall 5 year survival of cancer. This is the gross internal product of a country, down here, so this one. And the area of the circles is the percentage of the gross internal product devoted to health. So this is one of the main explanations. You see that all the countries in which we had the poorest results in terms of survival and also in mortality and so on are those with a lower. Gross internal product, and also with a lower gross internal product devoted to health. So it's one of the very simple and very effective explanations that have to influence policies. In any case, in crude figures, every year the global burden of colorectal cancer is like that. 145,000 deaths, and the 5 years prevalent, that means the number of sick people with colorectal cancer every year is around 800,000. These are the figures of significance. And we offer this data for the proper consideration to health administrators and politicians. And remember, colorectal cancer is a preventable disease. So these figures are unjustified. Thank you very much.